Hey, what's going on, guys? Power GPU here. Today we're going to do a not a really quick run, but a somewhat more steady survival type, trying to stay alive type run. We're doing the Nightfall for this week. This is from the new expansion or DLC that just came out for the Dawning for Destiny. And just to go over the stuff I'm running, I'm running the Hunjuri. I'll be running the Ex Machina sniper rifle, and of course the Galahorn, the famous Galahorn. I'm running Defender Titan with Blessing of Light, not Armor of Light. Blessing of Light worked out a little bit better for me on this one, so kind of use it, to survive. Definitely use it to survive. Pretty much what this Nightfall requires is some patience, taking cover, making sure you stay alive. Other than that, it's not too difficult. It's a matter of you knowing how to use, the corners, kind of stay alive, and of course, make sure you have that heavy ammo. Since speaking of that, that's why I have the gauntlets from the raid, because the gauntlets from the raid do drop more heavy as well. So the Galahorn does come into play a lot in this Nightfall. So I definitely recommend it. I wouldn't use any other rocket launcher to do this. And you want something with range as well, as far as your primary goes. Hand cannons, you could use a hand cannon, but I still prefer the Hunjuri with the Firefly. It definitely helps out quite a bit. So that's pretty much it. I'll let you guys enjoy the rest of the video. I'll come back and talk to you a little bit more once we get to the boss. The little kind of tricks and tip what to do there at the end. So I'll let you guys enjoy the video. See you in a little bit.
Taken have been aimless since their king's demise. For them to concentrate their forces here means they understand the value of the Nexus Mind.
If they've taken it, we can still blow it up. I'm reading a massive barrier ahead.
Cade, I appreciate the support, but don't you have other responsibilities?
Look, current situation aside, the Guardians have things handled. Doesn't leave a lot for the Hunter Vanguard to do.
If you're bored, the Warlock Halls could always use a once-over with a mop.
What was that? You're breaking up.
Thank you.
barrier would have taken considerable resources to power. I think they're scared.
Validate that fear, Guardian.
Alright guys, so now we're at the final boss. We're at Nexus. Pretty much on this part, what you want to do is you want to make sure there's a corner which I'll I'm going to show you here in a minute. It's the best spot to land in. It's going to be right up here to the right. I'll show you real quick. Oh! That didn't work out. Let's try this again. Yeah, you're not supposed to be jumping in this Nightfall, by the way. Heads up. As you can see there, you get melted pretty heavily. I had to throw in that footage, of course. You gotta show some of the times you fail. It can't be a perfect video. What's the fun in that? Then it's not fun. Then it's just boring. Anyways, what you want to do here in the beginning, what I do here is I just take out the guy in the back here. Makes it a lot easier once you get down there. And you only want to use your rockets, your Gjallarhorn, for the adds. Which is one of the biggest mistakes I've seen a lot of people do in this raid, is that they start using the Gjallarhorn to shoot the boss instead of using the sniper rifle or your primary. The Hungjury and the Ex Machina do a ton of damage. So I recommend using those two when you need to DPS them. Which the only time I will use Gjallarhorn against the boss is going to be at the end when the last phase comes up, which, by the way, once you use the relic and take down his shield, there is no time on how long his shield stays down. It only launches the next phase once you get him down to a certain damage point. So pretty much here we take out this guy here and burn him with some heavy. So you always want to take out the Minotaur really quick here because he's going to damage you pretty well. Make sure you pop your heavy synths. Make sure you always, always, always have heavy ammo with you. If you don't, it's going to be a lot harder, for sure. But pretty much you stay in this back corner and wipe out all the adds. Once you wipe out all the adds, then you can go down and pick up the relic. Which, as you can see here, I'm kind of head glitching him a little bit. So when he shoots, it's hitting the bottom. Which, after a while, he starts shooting. He'll start realizing that he can't hit you. So he starts shooting upwards. So as you can see there, now he started shooting upwards a little bit towards the end. So we're going to take out these adds real quick. Make sure you take them all out before you jump down, because they will destroy you. Which I wouldn't really say this is... I mean, this is somewhat of a cheese. It's still a spot you can kind of somewhat hide. I mean, you can still die very easily if you don't take all the adds out at a certain amount of time. Because, like I said, they will bombard you, so you want to make sure anytime you see them, you got to clear them out as fast as possible. Yeah, there comes the Gjallarhorn comes in hand there a lot. A whole lot. Come on. Where's this last guy? Hello? Hello? Where are you? Like I said, you want to make sure you clear everything out. Do not go up that ramp. That ramp is death. So always try to make sure you go the other way. There's that Hobgoblin. There's one more. There he is. Alright, we should be clear. I see some heavy over there, so I want to go pick it up. So what you want to do is if you go pick up heavy, or if you pick up heavy, or if the relic's in a way where it's visible to the boss, which is, yeah, one thing you want to do is take out these crates. Cause they will kill you. But if it's an area where the boss can see you, the heavy or the relic, definitely pop a bubble on it. You'll get your super back very quickly, so you don't have to worry about it too much. Well, she almost got me there, so I'm going to stay back a little bit, make sure I regenerate my health. Come up top. Kind of wait a little bit. And here we go. So yeah, pretty much after you shoot him there, you just kind of head glitch him there a little bit. Keep shooting him. Yeah, see, now he starts shooting. He starts backing up a little bit and starts shooting upwards, so that's where he can get you. Definitely had to pop my bubble there. And you can kind of peek out a little bit since I'm using Blessing of Light. It makes it a lot easier. Like I said, don't be afraid to use your primary on this guy. It still does a lot of damage, especially if you're using the Hunt Jury. So like I said, you can take all the time you want, guys. Don't rush it. Just take your time. Once you do this part, you'll notice that there's no timer on reducing. Well, that's a major head glitch right there. There's no time as far as taking down his DPS. You literally, it's a damage type thing. So once you get him halfway, a quarter of the way, halfway, so on and so forth, it pops the next phase. So that's pretty much it. As you can see, it pops the next phase, and we'll kind of rinse and repeat, do the same thing over and over. And I'll let you guys enjoy the rest of the video. So I will see you next time. I will be streaming tonight as well, guys. So make sure you check me out there at twitch.tv/powergpu. So I'll be streaming tonight at 8:30 Eastern. That's when I normally stream. On Monday, Tuesdays, Thursdays, Fridays, and Sundays. And I'll catch you guys in the next one. Peace.
Korra? It's been fun. But I've got a legion of hunters to oversee, which is less fun than it sounds. I think they think I'm too hands-on.
Some of them just don't like you.
Wait, what?
You've done well, Guardian. For the time being, Venus continues to turn, despite our enemy's best efforts.